Everybody loves a holiday resort. No matter where you're from, if you're all over the world, you love to go on holiday, and people like their places to go and chill and relax. There was a place like that just in Jesus' time. It was called Caesarea Philippi, and it was up in the mountains and used to have the cool stream waters running down, and you have the cooler breeze up there, and it was very popular with holidaymakers. And so they would often go along to Caesarea Philippi. Now something else happened at Caesarea Philippi. When you went up the mountain there, you could look around. And in the back, you could see temples. Temples from the Syrian gods. Temple from the Roman gods. Temples from the Greek gods. And the temples were everywhere. And so you couldn't get up there without seeing a temple of some sort. Especially Herod's temple, which would have been shining with his bright white colours. You see, when Jesus took his disciples up there, he took them up there for a purpose. He was asking, you know, who do the people say I am? And some said, well, he thought they were John the Baptist. Some thought he was Elijah. Some thought he was Jeremiah or one of the other prophets. And so Jesus deliberately chooses this place as a backdrop to ask the disciples the question. I can understand why they thought it was Elijah. Maybe Elijah was the one who was supposed to come back according to Malachi. Maybe John the Baptist, like some thought he was reincarnated. Some thought Jeremiah was going to be the prophet that would come back and take all the temple stuff and put it back in its proper place. And so Jesus knew what public opinion was all about. But that wasn't the real question. Against the backdrop of all this religious background and all the temples, Jesus comes up and says, who do you say I am? Now that's a question we all have to ask ourselves. This isn't about public opinion anymore, this is about you and Jesus. Jesus asked the disciples, who do you say I am? And I could imagine them thinking about all sorts of weird and wonderful answers. But out of all the disciples, Peter is the one that comes and says, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. You see, all these temples around us are all dead gods. But Jesus is the Son of the living God, and he is the Christ, the Messiah. And we may be a little bit surprised that Peter is the one who got that question right. For once, he got it right. And Jesus says, well done, Peter. For once, you've got it right. You said the right thing at the right time. You've got it. Because Jesus' teaching ministry right up to that point was all about, who is he? Who is Jesus? What is he here to do? What is he all about? He spoke about his death, he spoke about his resurrection, and people didn't really understand what he was talking about. But the first part of Jesus' ministry was all about revealing who he was. But from that point, from Caesarea Philippi moment, Jesus then starts to talk about his real coming, the purpose, his death, burial and resurrection. That's why he came. And so I want to leave you with the question, who do you say Jesus is? Is he some great teacher? Is he just a good man? Or is he the Messiah, the Son of the living God? That's something you're going to have to choose. God bless you, and have a great day.